Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.
Select your questions well, because you have a limited time, and such exams basically test your time management skills more than your aptitude skills. Hello everyone, my name is Utkarsh Motwani and I have been offered admission into XLRI Jamshedpur for the batch of 2022. I did my schooling from Bhopal only, from my graduation as well from Bhopal. My scores from 10th standard were 9.2 CGPA, then in 12th was 78% and 64% in graduation. I did my graduation in BE Automobile Engineering. And after that, I worked in Tata AIG as a graduate engineering trainee in the motor claims department. My CAT percentile was 98 and my ZAT percentile was 99.96, in which the sectionals were 99.29 for quant, 99.8 for verbal, and 94.2 for decision making section. The basic difference that lies between CAT and ZAT exam is the difference of decision-making section in ZAT and the LRDA section in CAT. Very different parameters to prepare for these two sections become the base of the difference in these two exams. Basically, the work I was doing in Tata AIG was more of a technical and analytical work profile. And I even used to interact with a lot of my colleagues who were in the finance or marketing domain, working for the underwriters to assess the loss or related to insurance related policies. So the work profile that they were involved in kind of really amazed me and made me pursue that profile. You know, when I used to interact with them, and it kind of gave me confidence that, yeah, even I want to pursue this profile. And one of the ways to pursue such a profile is to go for an MBA or go for a managerial position. So an MBA seemed helpful for that. I did not have a very specific goal of a single college. I was targeting the IIMs and the XLRIs or the FMS. Due to my less CAT percentile, 98 percentile, I did not get calls from the top six IIMs. So that was not a good thing for me. So that's why I shifted all my focus to the that exam, so that I could still target a really good college, a top five college out of that. So for the CAT exam, I basically started my preparation from June 2019. And I think 6 months of time was more than enough for any individual who has a basic knowledge of what all subjects are there in quant or in verbal. So I also took a coaching, and through that I started to categorize the subjects I want to take each and every day. For example, on a single day, I would take 2 to 3 hours and prepare for two couple of sections, for example, quant or verbal. So the basic thing was in mind was to first master the concepts and then move on to the other level of difficulties. I was not that good at reading, and I wanted to increase my speed at first so that I could get hold of the gist of the passage. That is very important in a smaller amount of time. So I started reading newspapers, specifically the editorial section of good newspapers like The Hindu or The Guardian. If you start reading about different topics, you get to know how do you get to the gist of the passage, which is very important when you're giving the exams. I used to improve my vocabulary by memorizing the word meanings. I used to record word meanings in my own voice, and I used to listen to them for 10 to 15 minutes or in a day. That gave me really helped a lot. Focus on your strengths and improve your weaknesses is the can be the mantra of, you know, scoring well in any section. So you get to know about the different types of questions, and it is important to go through every type of question, because you don't know what comes at the D-day. First, try to master the problem and then try to minimize the time by looking at the solutions which can get you to the answer in minimum time. So the first 20 to 25 minutes in the quad section is important to solve those questions in which you are good at. Somehow knew that it might get a notch above in the difficulty level as compared to CAT, especially in the VARC section, because it involves a couple of questions on poems as well. So if you are a person who does not have a good history with reading poems and getting into the depth of what the poet is saying, you might have a hard time answering the questions. And it did happen with me, because when I analyzed the question on poems and all, I did not have much confidence that I could solve it. So it is better to either leave the question, because it also gives you an advantage of getting more time to solve the other questions. So it is important to choose your strengths in the verbal section. If you're good at verbal ability part, the para jumbles, odd one out, you ought to focus that on that first. And similarly, in the verbal ability section, you can choose the elimination strategy to rule out the options that you can definitely see cannot be the answer. So even this method helps in scoring well in the verbal ability section. The main difference between CAT and ZAT lies in the decision-making section. And for me, the decision-making section basically focuses on your emotional quotient, the EQ. It's basically a test of how well you are able to put yourself in the shoes of a company's manager. How well are you able to empathize with him and take decisions do not take rash decisions, do not take very emotional decisions. It is basically a section which gives you real life problems that you can have in a company, be it related to ethics or be it related to firing some employee or hiring some employee, any kind of questions related to, for example, with an HR manager or any manager. This strategy will help you a lot, firstly to identify the stakeholders, then to see which is the best decision for all of them. Lastly, if I want to talk about the quant section, it's basically you have to focus on your accuracy. And when I saw my result, when I got to know of my marks, I was really happy, not because of my percentile, but because of the accuracy. This is what you should focus on basically in the quant section. So when I complete my mock test and I go for the analysis, are the answers really in a good format that can be understood even who is new to the mock tests? This is one factor. Other than that, I would really look for if the time is being given for each and every person who solved the question, for me who solved the question, and how much it is far than the average time taken for solving this question by all other students. This gives me a really helpful insight of knowing that which areas I spent more time on and which areas I am good at. So these are the two factors basically, what I used to realize from the solution of the questions is what, where did I went wrong firstly, in which parameter did I went wrong. For example, if there was a question in the DM section where I had to be less of a practical approach and more of an emotional approach. If it's about firing an employee who unknowingly did a mistake and is a very good performer. So a practical decision would always say that you have to fire that employee because he did a mistake. That is not acceptable. But on the other hand, you also have to look at the emotional quotient and think in a very ethical manner that although he's a very good employee and he has done well in the past, also he did this mistake unknowingly. So we can give him the benefit of the doubt. These are a few approaches that you have to keep in mind if you are solving the decision-making section. So basically the advice for future MBA aspirants, be it CAT or ZAT exam for that matter, any exam, the main advice is not to lose focus during the 3 hours, and one should not panic even if it's not going well for you, and select the right approach to solving the questions first of all. And the second thing is select your questions well. because you have a limited time, and such exams basically test your time management skills more than your aptitude skills. So this is the strategy that you should look for if you are giving the exam in 2020.
Hi guys, Inside IIM has come up with an exciting new one-on-one mentorship product where you get to interact with superstar managers from different businesses, different functions. You can ask them everything around your career, your education, your future success. If you are interested, the link is in the description below. Thanks.